Hello everyone, Skits here, and welcome to Top 10 Fallout New Vegas mods that came out in August, September, October and November 2018. In today's video I will be covering few big mods that came out recently, but also few small ones that I wanted to feature as well, so this episode might be a little bit shorter than usual. And now, without any further delays, let's get to it. Starting off, we have New Vegas Bounty Boards by Cerberus1211. This mod adds various bounty boards into towns like Good Springs, Prim, Novak, Camp McCarran, Freeside, Mormon Fort and New Vegas, where you can take on various quests. You can find at least two quests at each board, and each of them should take you around 5 to 10 minutes to complete, but since there are 7 bounty boards and 21 quests in total, it's gonna take you quite some time to finish this mod, maybe even around 2 or 3 hours. Now, what I really like about these bounty boards is that they fit into New Vegas world perfectly. Mater tried to fit these quests into lore of each town as much as possible, and thanks to that they really feel like they belong here. For example, in Prim, you will be tasked with courier jobs thanks to the fact that Mojave Express is located here, or in Novak, Nobark is going to send you on an adventure to find some alien treasure. Another thing I also liked is that there is variety in between these quests. So you have quests that ask you to repair something, hunt down people, solve mysteries, kill ants, and so on. Now, I think that this mod is best played when starting a new playthrough, since like I said, it really fits into the lore, and I can imagine these sort of bounty boards being in vanilla game as well. Morator is also planning on adding new bounty boards into various other locations like Cottonwood Cove or Crimson Caravan, so make sure you check it out in the future as well. Overall, a very good mod that adds a bunch of new quests into Mojave that fit into vanilla game as well, and I would definitely recommend it. Next up, we have Fallout 4 Power Armor features by MickCK and Dart B. Daman. This mod adds a few features from Power Armors that you could see in Fallout 4 into New Vegas. Now, when it comes to features themselves, we have things like Super Jump that allows you to jump really high by crouching and then pressing the jump button. This consumes 70% of your AP points, and you can even go into minus if you want, but then you have to wait until your AP points recharge above zero. Now, this super jump feature is really cool. Thanks to that, you can jump into really high places and maybe get a tactical advantage over your enemies. Another feature is an increased carry weight. This bonus is equal to the power armor's own weight. Another interesting feature implemented from Fallout 4 is called Pain Train. Now, if you keep your movement speed above a certain threshold for some time and run into your enemies, you're going to knock them out and usually kill them in most cases. You will need a perk for this to work, and like I said, you have to keep your movement speed above a certain level. Now, best way to use this Pain Train perk is to use a sprinting mod, for example one from Solid Project or Project Nevada. Another cool feature is that now you cannot wear unarmed weapons if you have a power armor, which is logical since you have very huge gloves. Instead of that, you can punch people with your fist and get a 25 damage bonus. Now, thanks to all of these new features, combat in power armor is a bit easier, and I had no problem decimating my enemies. There are also a few smaller things here. For example, in hardcore mode, you will not get as thirsty and hungry as before. The Tesla armor is now electrified, so if any enemy gets close to you, they will start suffering 5 points of electrical damage, and you can even sleep in power armor if you want. Now, most of these features can be also changed in mod configuration menu, where you can, for example, set if you want companions and NPCs to use these abilities too, and a few other small things as well. In the end, this is a pretty cool mod that I really enjoyed using, and it expands abilities of power armors, which is something I didn't saw in many mods before, so I would definitely recommend it. Moving on, we have Headhunting by The Overseer. This mod adds a brand new quest mod that can be started off by going to the Headhunting office that is located near Grab and Gulp. Now, if I have to compare this mod to something, I would say it is pretty similar to New Vegas bounties. In Headhunting office, you can find Joe that will hire you as a bounty hunter, and he will sell you contracts that you can complete. Thanks to these contracts, you're gonna be meeting some weird and interesting characters that you're supposed to kill. There are three categories of contracts. You're gonna be starting off with easy ones and then move on up after you complete a few contracts in certain category. When it comes to gameplay itself, it has a good mix of combat, exploration and dialogue. I especially like the dialogue interaction. All the characters I met so far were voice acted, and the voice acting was pretty good. When it comes to combat, it is pretty easy at the beginning since you're gonna be starting off at level 1 characters. But as you move on, it's gonna get harder and harder. Overall, there isn't really that much to say about it. Personally, I enjoyed it. It has good dialogue, some interesting characters, good combat, and if you enjoyed New Vegas bounties, you're gonna get something very similar here. So if you did enjoy them, then make sure you go ahead and check out this mod. Now let's take a look at LSO, a lightweight strip overhaul by Casoprt. If you always disliked how stripped looked more desolated than some other parts of the wasteland, even though it was supposed to be crowned jewel of this part of world, then you're in luck because Casoprt thought the same, and so he decided to change it up a little bit. In Vanilla New Vegas, you can see that strip is littered with junk, cars, destroyed roads, and casinos themselves don't look very good either. And now the roads are fixed, there is no junk whatsoever, no destroyed cars, and you can also see that casinos were improved. Now they no longer have destroyed walls, floors, and they're all clean and look very nice. Now if you're asking if this mod is compatible with some of your favorite strip overhauls, then it should be, but just to be sure, make sure to check out the comment section of the mod, where a lot of people already asked about some of these strip overhauls. Other than that, there isn't really that much to say about it. I mean, the strip now looks a lot cleaner and a lot better. Personally, I didn't even notice how bad the strip looked until I did a few comparison shots between Vanilla and this mod. Therefore, I'm going to be using this mod from now on, and I can only recommend it. Next up, we have increased NCR and Legion Wasteland patrols by Arius Valvius. This mod does exactly what it has in its name, and it increases the NCR and Legion patrols around the Mojave. Now we can find 4 new patrols, 2 for the NCR and 2 for Legion here. NCR patrols are moving between 188 Trading Post and NCR Sharecrooper Farms, and between Novak and Helios 1. On the other hand, Legion patrols are moving between Cottonwood Cove and Highway 95 Viper Encampment, as well as between the Legion Raiding Camp and Nipton. These patrols consist of 4 members, and you can talk to them just like you would to any other NCR trooper. So they don't really have any dialogue, and their main purpose is to basically repopulate Mojave a little bit and make it look like NCR and Legion have a bit of a bigger presence in Mojave. Now, I personally like this mod because it repopulates Mojave a little bit, and I was always a big fan of these mods that had new NPCs, because I think that Vanilla Wasteland is a bit too empty. And if you also share my opinion, then you should definitely go ahead and check out this mod. Moving on, we have NPCs Can Miss by Slap a Whole Tribe 23. As you may have noticed in Vanilla game, no matter who your opponent was, be it a super mutant or a drugged up fiend, they always had perfect accuracy. Even if they were far away from you, even if they used a shotgun or a sniper rifle, they could always hit you. Now if you use any combat mods that make it a bit harder to fight enemies, or any mods that increase damage, it is really hard to try and fight your enemies if they have pinpoint accuracy and you really can't do anything against it. This mod tries to change that by adjusting the NPC accuracy depending on their stance and weapons. For example, NPCs that run around will have harder time hitting you, while on the other hand, NPCs that stand, crouch or walk slowly will have better accuracy. One thing to note is that all of these settings were already in Vanilla game, but they were unused or the stats were set almost to zero. So thanks to that, there are no additional big scripts used, and your game shouldn't have any problems when you use this mod. When it comes to its actual performance in combat, I noticed that enemies do miss quite a lot now, so if you do try to use this mod, make sure you also use some other mods that make combat harder, so that it won't become too easy. I was a bit surprised that a mod like this one was not yet released, and so if you also want your enemies to have a bit more realistic accuracy, then this mod might be exactly for you. Now let's take a look at 3 smaller mods. First one is Calypso Wasteland Prophet by Calypso. This mod adds a brand new armor into the game. You can obtain them by crafting them at any crafting table for 1 scrap metal and 1 cap. There are 3 versions of this mod available, 1 hooded version, 1 where hoodie is down, and 1 version without pants. Now in my game, the hooded versions weren't working for some reason, and I had some pretty nasty bugs when I tried them, so the only one I could use was the one without hoodie. As you can see, it comes with custom textures and model. The textures look very good, they have some nice colors and quality. I think that this armor could really fit into Vanilla Wasteland as well. It has that post-apocalyptic feeling to it. Unfortunately, it is only for female characters. And like I mentioned, I noticed a few bugs in my game when it comes to hooded versions. Overall, it is a pretty nice armor mod that looks nice, fits into the wasteland, and I would definitely recommend it. Next up is Modern Kalashnikov 12 Weapon Pack by Raipe. This mod adds brand new weapons into the game that can be found in Novak in Player's Room. You can find 5 new weapons here, And as you can see, they all look pretty similar, but since it is a Kalashnikov collection, there can't be really any big changes between them. You can find two assault rifles here, one LMG, one sniper rifle, and one shotgun. As you can see, they come with custom textures and models. Now, I think the textures were a bit too shiny for my taste. Maybe it was because of EMB I use, but I felt like they really reflected the sun and looked kinda unrealistic and didn't fit into Wasteland that well. But their overall quality was pretty good, same can be said about models. When it comes to their use in combat, they were pretty useful as well. Thanks to the combination of assault rifles, shotguns and sniper rifles, I could use them in any situation, and thankfully they weren't overpowered or underpowered either. I'm using an Asura reanimation pack and they don't work really well with that one, so you have to bear that in mind. But in the end, this is a pretty cool weapon pack, and if you enjoy Kalashnikovs, then you should go ahead and check it out. Now let's take a look at Pip-Boy 2000 MK6 by Molten Clouds. This mod adds a brand new version of Pip-Boy into your game. There are two versions of this mod available. You can either use a replacer version, or you can also use an equipable edition that can be found at Wrecked Highwayman. Now this Pip-Boy is a part of a bigger project called Way of Chosen that is trying to bring Fallout 2 into Fallout New Vegas engine. As you can see, this Pip-Boy was inspired by the one that you can find in Fallout 76. It comes with a few special features. If you want, you can have a working date and clock at the bottom of Pip-Boy, but unfortunately you can't see it in my game since my FOV is a bit higher. It also comes with glowing stats, items and data buttons, and also with a nice visual grain effect that can be seen on screen. One thing I did notice though is that with this visual effect my Pip-Boy was lagging a little bit, especially when I was in the weapons category. I'm not sure if it was caused by this Pip-Boy or if it was just my game lagging, but I'm just letting you know that you might notice this as well. When it comes to the Pip-Boy's overall visual, I did like it. Personally, I think it is the prettiest wrist Pip-Boy here on Nexus. It has very good textures and models that were created from scratch. And even though it is originally from Fallout 76, I think it can fit in New Vegas world as well. So if you like this Pip-Boy a lot, you can check it out on mod page. And make sure you also check out Way of Chosen project that the modders are working on, because it looks pretty cool. And finally, we have Fallout New California by Radiant Helix Media. Now, I already created a separate review for this mod, so I'm just going to quickly mention it. New California features a brand new storyline with its own world, characters, story, weapons and quests. They will take you around 12 hours to complete. It features a branching storyline, some interesting characters and companions that you can meet, very good voice acting and some huge epic battles that are gonna be taxing on your computer, but a lot of fun to play through. Now at its release, the New California had a few bugs here and there and its performance was not that great, but modders are still working on it and they're adding new features, fixing bugs and just generally trying to improve it as much as they can. Like I mentioned in my review, I did enjoy my playthrough of New California. I admire modders for creating such a huge mod and sticking with it, and I think you should definitely play it as well. If you want to know more about it, then you can check out my review of it. I will be linking it in the description below. But like I said, a great mod, and you should definitely check it out. And yeah guys, I guess that's about it, so I hope you enjoyed this video. This time I didn't do a script for this top 10 because I was a bit lazy and I also didn't have enough time to create it. So if I sound different than usual, then it is because I kinda had to freestyle just like I did before. This will probably be my last New Vegas video until top 10 Fall New Vegas mods of 2018, which should come out sometimes around January or February. I will be making a few more Fallout 76 videos and I also have some other projects in mind, but since exams are coming up, I probably won't be able to release videos as much as I could until now, so there is a chance I might not release any new videos for 2 or 3 weeks. I would also like to give a special shout out to Simon Anderson and all the other Patreons that supported me this month on Patreon. Your support is very appreciated, and if you want, you can also donate. It really helps the channel out. The link for it is in the description, but if you can, it is okay as well, but just by watching my videos you're already supporting me and I'm thankful for that. And yeah guys, I hope you enjoyed this video, leave a like if you did, tell me what you think about it in the comments, subscribe for more Fallout and other games content, and I will see you next time.